The next chapter, chapter 8, cash book. Today we are going to discuss about cash book. Cash book is one of the original books. It is one of the original books, what we call as subsidiary books, or we call them as special journals. Now, what is the purpose for which we use this cash book? Cash book is used to record all cash transactions. Cash book is used to record all cash transactions. We have already discussed what is a cash transaction. A cash transaction is something where amount is paid. So when we say amount is paid, it may be paid in currency, what we generally call cash, or you can use other means like check, you can say a demand draft, you can also use your debit card, oblique credit card. So whenever you are making a payment, it becomes a cash transaction, or whenever you are receiving an amount, it becomes a cash transaction. Okay, so we say amount is paid or received. So in the form of currency or check or demand draft, debit card, credit card, etc., we call it as a cash transaction. So whenever you are paying through check, demand draft, debit card, credit card, etc., they affect your bank balance. They affect your bank balance. As a result, the balance in your bank account, that is balance of business bank account, either increases or decreases. Now, moving on to the next point, we say cash book is both a journal as well as a ledger. Now, the simple reason for it being journal is that you are using your cash book to record the cash transaction. The moment a transaction takes place, we immediately record in our journal. So whenever the number of transactions are more, we use special journals. As a result, whenever there is a cash transaction and you are using subsidiary books to record your transactions, the cash transaction is recorded in this journal, which is nothing but cash book. Now, why it is a ledger? Now, if you have seen, when you have studied the chapter journal entries, you have written journal entries, wherein by you have seen that many entries, there were many rather transactions or entries in which you debited cash and credited cash. You debited cash and you credited cash. Rather, when you compare the word cash with the other words or other accounts which you have journalized, there were either debit or credit for the others in majority of cases, but for cash, in majority of cases, cash was debited and also was credited. That means the importance of this cash account is that in some cases it gets debited, in some cases it gets credited. You very well know when it should get debited and when it should get credited, whereas with other accounts, they usually get debited or they usually get credited. So as a reason, if you see purchases was always getting debited. But one time when it got credited was when goods were taken to home by the owner for personal use. So as such, when compared to the number of purchases made and the number of times the goods were taken, the difference is very vast, very few instances. So but when you see the cash, several times you receive cash, several times you pay cash, as a result of the real account rule, it gets debited and credited. Therefore, it is the format of cash book, it is only the format of cash book which has debit side and credit side. Only the format of a cash book has debit side and credit side, because whenever you receive cash, you are going to record it on the debit side. Whenever you are paying cash, you are going to record it on the credit side. So whenever you are recording an amount on debit side and credit side, you can compare it easily. Now when you compare your debits with credit relating to particular head, you get their balance at a particular point of time. That is, for example, suppose you take any normal ledger. So in a ledger, what happens? Let us say I am writing X account, which you have done in the chapter ledger. Suppose there are some amounts on the credit, some amounts on debit. Ultimately, you are balancing. That means you are comparing these two amounts and arriving at some balance. So similarly, whenever you are doing cash book, there will be occasions when cash is debited, occasions when cash is credited. As a result, you enter the amounts on the debit side and credit side and ultimately compare both, the balancing figure will be either cash in hand or cash overdrawn. Now, what is cash in hand? That means the business is having cash with it or currency with it. What is cash overdrawn? That means the business has used cash more than what it has. As a result, this money could have come from borrowing, etc., which it needs to repay. That is a different issue. Now, moving on to the next point, real account rule. Basically, when you learn the rules of applying debit and credit, you learn, you classified the accounts. That is, through analysis, you said whether it is a nominal account, personal account, or a real account. And if you see, cash is a real account. So we apply the rule of debit what comes in and credit what goes out when we are dealing with this cash book. For many reasons, even when we say check, demand draft, etc., etc., this bank also you can treat it as the real account. Though traditionally bank is a personal account, you can use the rule of real account for bank also. That is, whenever you are depositing money into the bank, you can say money is coming in. Whenever you are taking out money from bank, you can say money is going out or you are making a payment. So coming to the last point, that is types of cash book. We have several types of cash book. You can say single column cash book, single column cash book. So when I say single column, you can say the format of cash book is nothing but just like that of a ledger, because we are saying cash book is also a ledger. So there is no difference between the format of a ledger and that of a cash book. Now, when I'm saying a single column cash book, in the amount column, that is in the amount column, we record cash paid or received. Now, when I say cash paid or received, it can be currency. Now, take some modern businesses. They don't use currency in their payments and receipts. At the same time, they would be using their, what you can say, the modern methods of transferring funds or receiving funds through banks. So in such a case, you can say cash book, single column cash book, in the amount column, we will be recording the amounts received and paid through bank. So it's not compulsory. Single column means only currency should be recorded. Based upon number of times your bank or cash account is getting affected, you can decide whether to enter the bank amounts in that column or cash. Let us say you have some 20 transactions in the problem. You have some 20 transactions in the problem in which 18 are related to bank, 2 are only related to currency. Therefore, in such a case, it is advisable to record all these 18 bank transactions in the amount column of your single column cash book. Then we can say it is a single column cash book with bank as its amount column. Similarly, you have a double column. You have a double column cash book wherein by there are two amount columns. There are two amount columns. Now these two amount columns, the combination could be cash, bank, it can be cash and discount, or it can be a combination of bank and discount. Okay, then the last, the third one is triple column cash book. Triple column cash book. Now in a triple column cash book, usually the columns are, typically your triple column cash book, the amount columns will be cash, bank, discount. Suppose you are not at all using the currency, you can have the other column for another bank account if you have, so that there will be only bank columns and discount columns. But practically in the question which you have a triple column cash book with cash, bank and discount columns only.